experience, I know how exactly how it feels to be a victim of road rage. So, I'm coming back. I just had breakfast with my friends at our favorite breakfast place over the summer. Beautiful, sunny August morning. We're driving back. I had my windows down, my shades on. Taylor Swift, of course. So I'm driving home, like, no worries in the world. And then in my rearview mirror, out of the corner, I see this blue car approaching. We're going, coming down a hill, and he's flying down the hill. So I was like, geez, okay, this guy's going fast. So I just think nothing of it. Keep driving. And the guy comes and just comes right behind me, starts tailgating me. So I was just like, okay, this is weird, but I didn't think anything of it. Keep going for another mile. I'm like, still, like, right behind me. I look at him. So I was like, okay, I see what this guy, you know, is up to. So I look at him through the rearview mirror, and he's a big guy. Like NFL linebacker, he's got a hat, but it's like over his eyes. He's got sunglasses on, so I can't see his face at all. So I was like, I don't really want to tangle this guy. Like, he's tangled with this guy. He's bigger than me. Like, you know, I'm not gonna do anything. So the two lanes, we're in a two lane road, and we're gonna merge into one. So I was in the correct lane to merge, and he was coming in the other lane, and he tried to like swerve around me, and I like was already merging, so I like went in front of him. So I was just like, okay, like, something's up. Like, what did I must have done something to piss this guy off. Keep going. Like, another mile is my neighborhood. So I was going to pull into my house. So turn into my neighborhood, and he turns in behind me. So I was like, oh, shoot. My neighborhood is, like, it's a huge circle. There's only one entrance. And my house is, like, the exact middle. So you can only go in one way, and then you can go, like, either right or left. It's a huge circle. So I make a right going in, still following me. I was probably going 20 miles per hour. It was like a 10 mile per hour speed limit in my neighborhood. Like, very, you have to go really slow. They're pretty strict about a lot of little kids and stuff. So I go back toward my house, and he's still following me. So I didn't want to turn into my driveway, because just in case, like, he turned behind me. So once I passed my house, I was like, okay, this isn't one of my neighbors, because he would have gone the other way coming to the neighborhood. So now I start to freak out a little bit. I was like, okay, this is definitely like a road rage incident. Like, I'm actually scared for my safety right now. Make a full loop around the neighborhood, and then just keep starting to make another circle. This time, the guy starts to get aggressive around me. He's flipping me off. His fists are in the air. He's shouting at me. He's like just acting crazy. So I call my dad. I was like, Dad, I'm in my neighborhood. Like, there's this guy that's been following me for miles. Like, I don't know what to do. So my dad, I never forget the words of my dad. So he's like, Jack, call 911. I'll be there in 5. So, hang out with my dad, call 911. I was like, 911, like, I'm in my neighborhood. Like, there's this guy following me. Like, I don't know what to do. And this woman that was an operator was a woman. She's like, okay, like, it's okay. Like, everything's going to be okay. Like, keep going around your neighborhood. You're doing fine. Like, don't pull in your driveway. Like, I was like, yeah, he must be on some kind of drugs or something. He's throwing his fists at me. Like, I don't know, like, what to do. She's like, okay, like, the officers will be there shortly. Like, everything's going to be okay. Stay on the line. So meanwhile, while all this is happening, my dad is close personal friends with the head sheriff of my county. So he's like, the guy's a pretty big deal. The county's pretty big. It's like a million people. So he's calling him up. He's like, okay, like, my son is going through this and this. Like, what should we do? So the head sheriff of the county was personally on his way with his entire squad of cop cars, personally on the way to the neighborhood. So I was still making loops, and I've probably gone up to maybe 35, 40 at this point. So we're flying around the neighborhood. And he kept trying to, like, cut me off. And, like, the road can only fit, like, one car. So he's like, I don't even know what he's trying to do. So I, like, swerved. Like, I didn't want to get in front of me or get to my side or anything like that. So probably made 3-4 loops around. And I'm still on the phone with the operator. She's like, okay, like, it's okay. And I was like, oh, like, panicking. Like, oh, my gosh. I don't know what to do. I was sweating. And she's like, okay, less than a minute, the cops would be here. So I'm like, oh, my gosh, thank God. So around the neighborhood. The guy takes his hat off and his sunglasses off and sticks his hat at the window. It's like, holy shit. Like, it's my buddy from high school. It's my friend. He's not the sharpest knife in the drawer, as you can tell. His name's Tyler. And I pull over to the side of the road. I'm like, man, I'm so sorry. Like, I know this guy. Like, just, you can call off everybody. And he pulls up to the side of me. He's like, hey, Jack, like, good to see you. Like, and I had my grad party like a week ago. He's like, thanks so much for having your party. Like, it was awesome. I was just like, Tyler, like, dude, what are you thinking? And he's like, I just want to say hi. Like, I saw your car. Like, I just want to say hello. And I was like, dude, I called the cops on you. So he's like, why? Why'd you call? And he's like, oh, like, yeah, I can see why. I think. Real big kid too, like huge. So I was like scared. And he drove away, and my dad pulls in. He had the car, by the way, it was a brand new car, so I didn't recognize his car. My dad pulls up next to me. He's like, Jack, like, you all right? I was like, yeah, fine. My dad's like, what happened? I was like, it was one of my buddies. He's like, who was it? I was like, oh, it was Tyler. My dad knows he's kind of a little on the dumber side. So he's like, oh, like, that makes sense. I don't really want any friends. So that was just a funny story I want to share with you guys. Moral of the story is some friends will do anything just to say hi, which is great, I guess. And lastly, I know what victims of road rage go through, so it's not fun. You should call the cops if you're in road rage. So thanks for listening, guys.